morning, a man seemed to be passing by. You know, God, you see, in Isaiah 44, verse 8, I mean, you know, I want to go off. There's a saying that anytime there's a poor person, there's a help for the poor person. So in the struggle of this idiot, and you know what is worse? When you are special among people, and you don't belong to them, you fall amongst them, they always hate you. If you look at the city, how blessed you are, how anointed you are, and how gifted you are, maybe you're not supposed to belong to this group of people. And because you are among them, they will hate you and make you feel as if you're not human. Because they get jealous of you, because they get envious of you, because they are worried about your presence. But I said, no matter the place where you are, God is not missing you yet. I said, no matter what is going on in your life, God is not down to you yet. Somebody never know. After a long time of pain and hatred, one day a man seemed to be passing by. When the man heard the sound of the eaglet crying, he stopped. He said, this animal doesn't belong here. Why? Why are you here? Why are you struggling like this? Why are you in so much pain? Why are you on this struggle? When he entered the house, he said, he told the man, this animal doesn't belong here. I could feel the pain of this man. I could feel the heart-wrenching pain of this animal. It doesn't belong here. It belongs to God. The owner said, no, it is mine. I'm never going to allow it to go anywhere. But after a long time of struggle, like the Bible says in the book of Matthew, Luke 19, just like the, I want to football guy, right? A football guy friend was, what's the name of them? Monkey, donkey, the Bible says, Jesus said, there is a colt ahead of you. Listen very carefully. It has been bound since childhood. It has never had an opportunity to move. Go ahead of the town. Go there. When you get there, go and untie it. He says, the owners will tell you, why are you untying it? Tell the owners, the Lord of Lords, the King of Kings says, it is time for your liberty to be here. If you are here, just like the eagle, the Bible said when the man entered the house, the owner said, I'm not going to allow it. But the man struggled for a long time. After a long time of struggle, the man picked the eagle. Listen very carefully. When he picked the animal, he was trying to throw you so that they could fly. But if you've been poor for a long time, you know you are afraid to the rest. If you've lived poor for a long time, sometimes when somebody tells you I'll give you $1 million, so when the man picked the bed and tried to throw it out, he came back on the ground because all its life, what he knows is to walk on the ground. My sister, maybe you're on the ground, but I'm speaking to you, you don't belong here. God is about to elevate you to the next level. God is about to elevate you to the next level. God is about to elevate you to the next level. God is about to elevate you to the next level. God is about to elevate you to the next level. God is about to elevate you to the next level. God is about to elevate you. 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 First trial, he came down. Then the man tried again to throw it higher. Then he came down. Then on the third time, listen very carefully. This man was trying to help his bed. On the third time, he took the bed to a higher mountain where it is so high because on a higher mountain, Jesus Christ was crucified on a mountain. So in order to save the bear to the place where it belonged, the man took the bear to a higher mountain. Because anytime they be threw up, the bear always comes down because on the ground it's so easy to come down. But this time when he took it to a higher mountain, the man threw the bear over. The bear was scared that it was going to die. So what it did was it opened its wings. maybe thinking that this is my last. But when it opened its wings, in the struggle and the fear to die, when it clapped, it wasn't going down, but it began to go up. And as a Christian, for you really to be blessed, God has a way of stirring you up.
Amen.
And sometimes He brings troubles and anxieties to you. Amen. When you are afraid that your end has come and your weakness, then God's strength becomes perfect. So if you are here, troubles and anxieties on a higher mountain where you think your end is coming, I am speaking upon your life that this is not your end. That you are about to get to another level. 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 I said you are about to get. Somebody is about to get to another level. 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 Amen.
Jeremiah chapter 8, we're reading from verse 1. It's a word that came to Jeremiah from the Lord.
He said, a word came from Jeremiah. A word came from the Lord. Jeremiah,
go down to the potter's house, and there I will give you my message.
God, listen to me very carefully. If God wants you, that's why everybody, you need to learn to be very humble. As a Christian, if you don't have this miracles, you've done a mistake. The reason why King Saul failed, but King David succeeded, was humility.
Amen.
You are blessed. You are anointed. And nobody is bigger than God.
Hallelujah.
When God wanted to speak to the nation Israel, He sent Jeremiah that he should go down to the potter's house. God can speak through my father to me. If I am humble, my life will be saved. God can speak to Bishop to me. Son, watch this and be careful. If I don't snub him and I pay attention to him as a father, God will use him to save
them.
For God to save Israel, He sent a prophet called Jeremiah that he should go to the house of the potter. You know who is a potter? Obi Oyekunpo. Somebody who uses clay to form anything. Clay or man to form anything. But do you know that, as the Bible says in the book of Genesis, humans, we are made from clay. Oyekunpo. Mm-hmm. As humans, we are formed from clay. And growing up, we used to play with clay. Have you played with clay before?
Yes.
You know how you can just form it, break it, put water on it, and then it becomes, you can always use it for something like that. So when God wanted to speak to Israel, He spoke to a prophet, go down to the house of the potter, and then I will speak to you.
Draw me close to you. Never let me go. Let me go.